So in today's video, we're going to take a look at some shady dev jobs. Real quick, thank you for 100,000 subscribers. It means a lot. I got to keep pushing forward, got to keep moving, got to keep hustling. When I was 10% of the way to 100,000, I was like, oh, I got to keep going. Now I'm 10% of the way to a million, which is insane. So I got to keep going. Anyways, there's one specific interview that I had a little bit ago. It was like one of my, before I even finished the code bootcamp, I was like looking up these cool remote jobs. Because if you don't know, I wanted to work remote. That was like literally the only reason I learned how to code, because I didn't want to go to the office anymore. And I didn't think that I needed to be in an office. So when I Googled remote jobs, they were all coding jobs. So when I was going to boot camp, I was already on my way, looking for remote jobs, Googling away. And I used to write Medium articles about how I was so excited to be in the dev world and how I was just like, I just couldn't wait to get a job and I couldn't wait to get remote. And so I started building my brand. Anyways, I have this on the screen here. So here I am, I got my very first Rails job, a little part-time one. I work 7 days a week, 4 days at my full-time engineering job, part-time developer, blah, blah, blah. I'm like super excited about being a developer before, you know, I kept getting let go and screwed over and, you know, companies kept running out of money. Before all that happened, I was so excited. I was the best employee ever. And so I started looking at future possibilities here. This doesn't even sound like me. Of course, I've started looking at future possibilities with the stack I'm learning. So a few companies I found are Mossio and a small company, something I'm familiar with, Creative and Relaxed. One of the cool things about that company was they worked 4 days a week and they took Fridays for self-learning, kind of like Google, I guess. I was super excited about this company. I was like, oh my God, I gotta work here. This is like the dream job. And they had this cool culture and like they had these cool company videos. I was like, oh, I have to work here. Absolutely have to work here. And so after I got let go from my React job and I couldn't find a job, I saw a job posting for this company. And I was like, what? I have to work here. I applied and I was like, look, I even wrote a blog post about you guys like 4 years ago. And they were like, oh wow, that's awesome. Wow, we just read it and we're super excited. We definitely want to interview you. So I did the interview and they were really kind of, it was just the founders, the two co-founders and the CTO. And they were really excited to like move forward with the process. They didn't really want to do a code test with me. And they were just like, yeah, look, sounds good. Let's do it. Yep. And I was like, this seems like way too easy. Was it just because of the blog post? And they're like, no, we just have, you know, our CTO is about to leave and we need someone to pick up the project. And I was like, oh, okay, well, yeah, let's set up another time and the CTO can pass down his knowledge to me and then I'll keep developing from there. And so they're like, all right, cool. We'll get back to you in a couple days and we'll figure out a day and we'll schedule it. And during that time, I thought it was a little weird how fast they wanted to hire me, how pushy they were with the hiring process. And I was like, all right, this seems kind of weird. No code test. They just wanted to hand down the knowledge right away. I set up another call and we hopped on the call again. And I did like this little like walkthrough with the CTO of like their application and stuff. I was asking, I was like, okay, so what are we doing? He's like, oh, we just have this client here. We just need to get this done. I have another job that I'm going to go do. I was like, okay, all right, cool. And then he's like, all right, so here's what you're going to do. I was like, okay, what happens after this contract is over? And they were like, well, you know, we're a design shop first. So that was the first thing that stood out to me. We're a design shop first. Design shop, which means they have clients coming and going all the time. They're like a dev shop. Clients are coming and going and working with a bunch of different companies all the time. Like, okay. And I was like, but what happens when, if you leave and I take your contract, what happens here? Do I not have a job anymore? It's like, oh, no. We usually have stuff coming down the pipeline. You know, it's never been a big deal. I was like, okay, cool. But I was still suspicious. I still have my doubts. I was like, what is going on here? So after that, we were going to set up another final call to like go over some more stuff. And during that time, I felt just a little bit too suspicious. It seemed too good to be true. I was like, you know how many code tests I did before this? And they were way harder than this. And this just seems really, really too good to be true. And I noticed that there like no other developers were part of the interview. It was just me and the CTO. And I was like, that's kind of weird. So I started going on LinkedIn and I was looking at employees that worked there previously. And as I was looking at employees that worked there, I noticed that no one was working there anymore. They had all been let go around the same time, or they'd all said that they all ended, I guess. Their LinkedIn said that they ended. So I pulled it up and you can see here. And so now if you Google this company, you'll see that there's only like two people there or three people. Like one guy doesn't have a picture and the two co-founders. And so what it looks like this company does, it was such a reality check because it was my dream company. So it looks like what this company does is like they just run through different people. They hire people as needed and let go. It's like they tried to expand too fast. Because as I look through LinkedIn here, you can see every time I pull up somebody and I scroll down, we have product designer January 2015 to August. And then I found another one March 2016 to 2017, but it doesn't say when he left. I Googled another one, and it was November 2015 to May 2016, engineering director as another one. Oh, creative director and product designer. So this is where I got all the info on the company when I was researching it. And I was like, oh, this looks super cool. He's got all these cool videos about culture, and he's writing about how we create a great startup opportunity, blah, 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 blah. Stuff that I didn't really know anything about, but it just got me super hyped because it was remote and it was only 4 days a week, and they were like super pro, you know, you do you. August 2015 to July 2017. And then I found another guy. October 2016 to July 2017, so same as that guy. And I found another guy. December 2015, January 2017. I found another one, right? April 2015, May 2015. So he was just contract. He was just brought in and let go, just like that. And then August 2014, August 2015, again, brought in and let go. And as I started to do the research on this company, I noticed that they just had this trend of hiring people and letting people go. And these weren't just like little people, like engineering director hired and fired. And so what they were doing is they're just looking for someone to fulfill that final moment, because the CTO, I guess he had enough, or I guess he's like, look, man, I can't do this. I'm out. And so they just needed to replace him with somebody. And that somebody was going to be me. And as I kind of figured that out, I sent them an email. I was like, yeah, no, I don't think it's going to work out. I think I'm going to have to pass on this opportunity, but I appreciate it. Thanks so much. And this was like my dream job a few years before I actually had this opportunity to interview. I was so excited. I told all my friends I was interviewing there. I told like my family. I was like, I even wrote a blog post about this place. Like, cause I was in a pretty bad spot. I didn't have much money left, and I'd finally secured an interview. I was almost out of money, almost homeless, finally secured an interview. And lo and behold, it was at my dream job. And as I just did the research here, I discovered their outward appearance was nothing like what they actually operated as. And I guess the point of this video is that research these companies, do the background checks, especially if it's one of these small startup companies and that's what you're all about. You're all about this cool startup culture like I was, wanting to work remote especially. Do the research, look into it, make sure that they're not just outwardly looking like they're a fantastic company, but on the inside, you would never know. And if you go to their page now, you can see that there's only a few people there. So we have the, like, director, managing partner. So these are the two co-founders, and then some other guy, that lead installer. I don't even know what he does. I think he accidentally works at a different company, but LinkedIn put him with these people. There's only two people there. I don't know what they're doing anymore, but made me overly cautious about everything I was doing going forward. And I want you guys to do that. So if you see a dream job out there and you get that opportunity, look on Glassdoor, check reviews. Look on LinkedIn and see who worked there before and see how long they worked there before. Because to me, this was just a giant red flag that, like, I was going to get hired and I was going to get fired. I was going to be done. And that was it. And they weren't going to tell me that. They just wanted someone to complete the project. And that's why they were so pushy on me moving forward. They just wanted to get me in and I guess get me out. And as I figured that out, I think they were like, well, okay, thank you. And like it... To me, it was a reality check, and to them, they didn't care. They just want their bottom line. And I guess maybe that was the first moment I felt like really, really like expendable, knowing that if I were to accept this, I may or may not, probably won't have another job, because at that time, they wouldn't give me a straight answer when I said, do you have another contract lined up? And they're like, well, first and foremost, we're a design shop. But that doesn't answer the question, like, will I have more work, and will I still have a job after I finish this? Well, you know, usually we, like, what's the answer here? Just tell me straight, like, because if I'm gonna take this job working contract, I'm not gonna be able to focus the entire time I'm working this job, because I'm gonna be looking for another job knowing that in a few months I'm not gonna be able to pay my mortgage. And so you guys are both designers. Both of the managing partners are designers. They're both designers, and I'm a developer. And so you need me because you promised a client some work, and your CTO is leaving because he's probably tired of your shit, and you need someone to complete the contract or else you'll probably get sued. And it just kind of all unraveled in front of me. I hadn't done Rails in a long time. Like I quit my Rails job way back. And I thought it was because they wanted to hire me because I wrote about them and I was super excited about them. And I think they were just trying to take advantage of me. And I was really expendable, and it was not a great feeling. I just wanted to share this experience with you, and I just want to tell you guys to like make sure that these companies aren't letting people go left and right, and like look at them, look at what they're doing, look who's worked there before, see how long they worked there. Check to make sure that like you're gonna have more work, and if you get hired on for a project, ask what project you're gonna be hired on to work. Ask what the team is that you're gonna be working on. Ask how you get more work. Ask the companies like, okay, well, if I'm getting hired on for this project, you know, you need more devs because you want to get it done or whatever. Whatever the reason is they're hiring, what's after that? What happens after that? Because you might not have a job. And I guess if like that first guy, it looks like he was there for a year. What people do when they lose their job and they go to get another job is that they leave it as marked as present. Even on my LinkedIn right now, I forgot to take off my teaching job because I didn't, you know, you usually let your jobs on LinkedIn just run until you get the next job, because otherwise you're gonna have a job gap and everyone's gonna be like, well, what happened there? And like, it shouldn't matter. It really shouldn't matter. You'd be like, well, I was taking care of my family. They were sick. Oh, okay, well, that's red flag. Okay, like, so what a lot of people do on LinkedIn is they'll leave their job marked as present until they get another job, and they won't remove it. And so that's really what I think happened to this first guy. Like, he worked there for 3 months and they let him go, but you can't find a job if you have that gap. I was really burned by that experience because I was so excited. It was like a dream job. Just, I don't want that to happen to you guys. So do the research, ask all the questions, ask to meet everyone, and always ask, and then what's after that? And after that, and what's the plan after that? That happened. That's how I got let go of my previous job. We were hired on for a project and they ran out of money and they didn't want to do anymore. And I was like, so what happens after this project? And the lead developer said, oh, don't worry about it. We'll probably just do some refactoring. This company's got deep pockets, which means, you know, if you're not from the US, they have a lot of money in the savings to pay while they hunt for new projects. But that didn't matter. That didn't matter. They just said, nope, bye. So that was a really... it was a really shady company, and I don't want that to happen to you guys. So just do the research, make sure that the company is gonna take care of you, even if it looks like your dream company. Sorry if this seems redundant. Just want to warn you guys. I was talking to my friend about this, and I was like, I should make a video about this to warn people, to help you guys out, so you don't have to deal with that. So you guys don't take the job and then realize, I don't have a job anymore, or I'm not going to, or just look for all the red flags that these companies try to disguise. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, maybe leave a thumbs up. Maybe hit subscribe. I'd appreciate that. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Help me get to 1 million subs. That doesn't sound as good. Let's say, help me get to 250,000 subs by the end of the year. Road to 250K. End of the year. Leave a comment for the giveaway. And I hope you guys have a great Monday. And I'll see you guys in the next one.